Hello filmmakers, welcome to Storitium. In today's After Effects Basics tutorial, we're going to recreate this writing on a chalkboard effect. Let's jump straight into the action and go over to After Effects. Inside After Effects, we're going to start by making a new composition. I'm going to do this by right-clicking in the project panel and select New Composition. For this demo, I'll use a 4K 3840 by 2160 resolution, but of course you can pick any resolution that you prefer. Now I'll hit OK and then we've got a brand new composition here in the project panel. I've also already imported a background for this tutorial. I found this background texture on Envato Elements. I will add a link in the description, but you can also find free ones on sites like Pixabay.com for example. Anyway, we're going to use this background texture and we're going to drag this over to the timeline. And as you can see, it is a little larger than the composition, so I'm going to scale it down. I've got the image layer selected, so I'm going to hit the S key on the keyboard to reveal the scaling properties. And then I'll scale it down to the point where it's just slightly larger than the composition. Okay, with the background in place, we can now add the text. And to do this, we need the type tool, which you can find here, or hit Ctrl plus T on your keyboard to enable it. I can just click somewhere in the frame and start typing. And for this demo, I'll type hello. And if you're done typing, you can go back to the selection tool by clicking this icon here. Now I'm going to resize the text, and if you do this while holding the Shift key, the proportions of the text will stay intact. Let's also reposition and align the text. Often it's also a good idea to add some more space between the characters for a better result with this effect. Something like this should be more than enough. For the next steps, make sure you've got the text layer selected and then head over to the Pen tool, which you can find here, or hit the G key to enable it. And now I'm going to draw mask lines by left-clicking in the frame. I'll do this in the same direction that I would normally write my characters to create a natural handwritten flow or look. Just take your time to add multiple points and try to stay in the middle of the character lines for the best results. I'm going to fast-forward this recording now so you don't have to wait. Okay, so now I finished the mask line that covers the word hello. In the next step, I'm going to apply the stroke effect. You can do this by going to the Effects menu on top and then go to Generate and select Stroke. Then head over to the timeline and open up the text layer and go to the Effect properties. Here you'll find the stroke effect that we just applied. The first option that I'm going to change is the paint style. I'm going to select Reveal Original Image. As you can see, the text has now disappeared, but when I play around with the start and stop value and also increase the brush size, the text will come back again. The start and end properties are used to animate the stroke. We want to start writing on the left, so that is why we're going to set end to 0. And then I will also set start to 0 and enable keyframes by clicking on the stopwatch icon here. Then I'm going to move a couple of frames forward and increase the start value until the first letter appears. And then again move a couple of frames forward and create another keyframe with the same value by clicking here. And then I'm going to repeat the same step for every letter. So I'm going to move a couple of frames forward, increase the start value and create another keyframe. And with these keyframes we create a little pause between the letters appearing on screen, which will make it feel a bit more natural. Anyway, I'm going to fast forward again so you don't have to wait. Okay, let's give it a playback to see what we've got so far. You can change the speed of the animation by playing around with the timing of the keyframes. So if you feel that the animation goes too slow, then you can move the keyframes closer to each other, for example. And that is exactly what I'm going to do with this demo. I'm going to move the keyframes closer to each other so the animation will go faster. And after that, you should have a result that looks something like this. That's it for this short tutorial video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please like the video, that really helps a lot. Anyway, thanks for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.